we'll get there. Don't worry. And then from there, we'll go right arm over the top.
Oh, sorry, yeah.
Switch. And then relax. We'll go ahead and stand feet together. And we'll start, go ahead, we'll rotate the head clockwise to the right. Reverse, back the other way. And relax. From there, we'll go ahead, feet out, shoulder length apart. Go ahead, get some space between you and someone else. I know we got a lot of people in here, so it's gonna be a little hard. But from there, try not to hit hands with anyone, and we'll go side to side. There we go, feet together. We'll come interlocking the fingers. As we take a deep breath in, we'll raise our hands to the roof. As we breathe in, we'll come up on the tiptoes. From there, breathe in. As we breathe out, we'll come down slowly. One more time, interlock the fingers and in. And out. One more time as we breathe in. And out. From there, we'll go ahead, take a deep breath in. As we breathe out, we'll bend down, touch the toes. Try not to lock your knees, remember, keep that small bend. And relax. One more time, we'll go ahead and breathe in. Go ahead, sit on down. We'll start off with our butterflies. Bring it in as close as you can. Get comfortable. Everyone good? From there, now reach your hands back behind you. Try to push down a little bit more if you can. Keep it nice and tight. Warrior. Go ahead, pull nice and tight. From there, go ahead and hug your knees. Sink it in just a little tighter. Hug those knees. Sink in. And from there, go ahead and relax. We'll bring the feet out. Breath in. As we exhale, we'll look over to the right, stretching the back out. And relax. From there, take a deep breath in. And to your left. And relax. One more time to the left. Take a deep breath in. And out. And from there, go ahead and we'll come back to the front. Take a deep breath in. And going down. And relax. Deep breath in. And out. And relax. From there, everyone go ahead on your feet. How's everyone feel?
Good.
I'm going to turn it over to the man of the hour, Master Philip.
It's my turn now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I'd like to wish you peace. My name is Philip Selmon. I've been doing these movements now. It'll be going on 42 years. I've been practicing these type of movements to the point where I became master teacher of the science, and I started doing things here in Arizona, also in Cleveland, Ohio, where my little brother was stationed at. He came out here and showed what he could do with the movements. I've always followed what he was doing. I saw him doing movements first. I was so impressed that I've been with it, trying to follow him the rest of my life up until now. So we've been doing this a while. It's a family thing, and we all enjoy it. I saw some of your movements when I first came in. I saw some of your forms. I also saw some of your stances. One of the stances I saw was the stance called three. So we'll start with our stance called three. We'll step with the left foot. Front leg is bent, back leg is straight. Both feet are at 45 degree angles compared to the body. Body's on a 90 degree. The stance is called three. When I'm in this stance, the smallest target is forward. Not to give a big target. We'll come back to the center. I also saw these moving horse stance. In this horse stance, my hands were chambered. Here is the big target. Don't want to get caught in this target. It's a big target. So I'll pivot, bringing the left hand to the hips, both hands to the hips. Front leg is bent. I should just barely see the big toe. Back leg is straight. Both feet are at 45 degree angles compared to the body. Body's on a 90 degree. Coming back to this position. In this position, you're off balance. You know you're off balance because you can take one finger. Place one finger right there at your forehead and just push your head back till you feel your toes come up. If you felt your toes come up, you know that you can push yourself off balance with one little simple finger. One finger will do it. The same way if you push your finger to the back of your head. Push till you feel your heels come up. That means you can push yourself down the street. So you want to move from off balance, pivot to the right shoulder fold, to on balance. In martial arts, Gung Fu, they call it perfect balance. I want to move from off balance to perfect balance. Off balance. Left shoulder, perfect balance. Off balance. Perfect balance. Off balance. From this position, I'm going to strike with the left hand, shoulder level. When I pivot, I'll strike. Then I'll bring it back. Opposite side, I'll strike, shoulder level. Coming back. On command, we'll move. Oots! Uts. 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 From the off balance to your perfect balance. When I go to the perfect balance stance, I'm striking. Uts. 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 Again, front leg is bent. Back leg is straight. That shows a balance of opposites. The bent leg is female. Leg that's straight is male. Feet are at 45 degree angles compared to the body. Body's on a 90 degree. Hips are tucked deep to protect the groin and bladder. So you protect yourself there just by the way that you move. Oots, big target. Oots, little target. Oots, big target. Oots, little target. Oots. Good, coming it up, shake it out. This time we'll come from here, we'll step with the left foot going that way. When I step, I'll bring my hands up. Good, we'll try it again, ready. Oops. Good, right hand is above, left hand is below. My hands are my shield. When I'm in this perfect balance stance, smallest target is forward. That means my shoulder is forward. Always protecting my center, protect center mass. When my body goes to this stance, my hands come up. It makes me even a smaller target. Coming back up. We'll go to the opposite side. We'll take this step, bringing the hands up. This time the left hand is above. Left shoulder is forward, left hand is above. Opposite hand protects the low body. Coming back up. You hear the command, go into your stance. Ready? Oops. Excellent, immediately. That's my shield. Always can't put your shield in front of your body. Don't have your shield behind your body or to the chamber to the side of your body. It's in front of your body. If anything touch me, I want this to touch my hands first. Not my head or my body, because my hands are my shield. Coming back up. Opposite side, ready? Oops. Good, when you're in your perfect balance stance and you're protected with your shields up. One hand protects the face, other hand protects the low body. I want to be able to see right above my fingertips. If my hand is in front of my eye, that's a blind spot. I don't want to create blind spots. I want to be able to see everything. I want you to be able to see it. And don't forget what you see. You saw it. Don't forget it. This time we'll come from here. We're going to pivot all the way to the opposite side. When I pivot, my hands will switch. Ready? Oops. Nice. I like your basic stances. Basic hand technique. Ready? Oops. Every time I switch, my hands will move. I want it to be a block. We make it a block by making it a half a circle. And it's like half a circle toward your shoulder. That becomes a block. We'll pivot. Oops, half a circle toward your shoulder. Everything past your shoulder is out in space. Ready? Oops. When I block, I want it to be a deflection. Deflection. Don't want to grab anything. Just want to deflect. Ready? Oots. 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 Every time you move, you're blocking. Protect yourself. Always practice your blocks. You don't want anyone hitting on you or touching you. So you learn to block. Ready? It's coming towards you. Oots. You block it. It kept coming towards you, you pivot and you block. Oots. Oots. Good, coming up, shake it out. This time when I step into my stance called three, I'll block down and bring my hand up. Coming back. When I block with the hardest part of the hand, that's the heel of the hand. I don't want to block with my fingertips because I can get those damaged. So I flex my wrist, blocking with the heel of the hand. I bring it past my body. Everything that's past this part of the body is out in space. I just need to take it that far, past me. Then I bring it back up to my position to protect my head. We'll try it again, ready? Oops. Good, try it again, ready, from your standing position. Ready, oops. Coming back. I try to make it like a circle, small circle. Which one is faster, the bigger circle or the smaller circle?
Small circle.
So it's a small circle. I make a small circle and I block. That small circle is fast. Ready? Oops. 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 Not only can I block with the right, I can block with the left. So we'll step the opposite foot and we'll block with the opposite hand. Ready? Oops. Oops. Now, when I block down, my hand, other hand comes above to protect my face. Once I block, my hands will switch. Ready? Oops. 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 Good. Your basic stances look good. Your blocks look good. Your strikes are looking good. This time we're going to come from here. We're going to take a step and we're going to turn to this position. Coming back, we'll try it again. Ready? Oops. 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 Nice. Oops. I like how you put 70% of your weight on the forward leg. Front leg is bent, back leg is straight. Try it again, ready? Oops. Oops. Remember, there's danger coming in these streets. Danger is in front of you. When you're in this position, you're off balance. You can push yourself with one finger going back or forward. You also have the big target. What these enemies or criminals in the street, where they want to aim is right at your center mass. So we're going to go through this stance again. Watch how you protect center mass. Oops. Oops. Good. Oops. Oops. Finding this stance. When this strike is coming, I don't want to get to this position and tense up like I'm mad because he's striking at me. That's how I get hurt. So I make this motion. First things to the smallest target possible. Even if this strike connects, I still go to that position. It's like water off the duck's feathers. I want to get to the smallest target possible. 70% of my weight is forward. Thank you, sir. Ready? Oops. How do I get to that stance without falling down? Coming back, try it again, ready? Oops. Oops. Nice, you got your stance and you're not falling down. This time I'll come from here and I put the right hand on the hip. Left hand, I'm pushing to the full extension. Coming back, ready? Oops. 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 How good of a martial artist are you when you move with one hand? So you practice on how good I can move with one hand. One hand, I'm dangerous with one hand. So I practice that. Could I demonstrate something?
Yes, sir.
First thing, how I get my body out the way. Second thing, how do I trap that hand? 70% of my weight is on the left leg, which is forward. So that means the majority of my weight is against his arm as I push down. So it's like, one, first thing, how do I jam this hand? One hand, he has two hands, I only have one. First thing is to jam this hand. Closer to his body, the better. Ready? Oops. First thing, I jam his hand. Stop his hand from moving on you. You can do it with one hand. Oops, try it again, ready? Oops. First you went to the smallest target possible to find your stance. Then you added what your shield would be doing. Trapping the hand. Don't let him reach in his pockets or in his pants to pull out something that hurt you. First thing, stop his hand, say, slow down. Try it again, ready? I want to jam that hand. Oops. Oops. Now, this time when I move, when I jam, I'll bring the back of the hand forward. Back of the hand. Try it again, ready? Oops. Push with the front of the hand, strike with the back of the hand. Let's try it again, ready? Oops. When I'm striking, I'm using the back of the hand. We call it in the martial art, the male side. The male side of the hand. Let's try it again, ready? Oops. The male side of the hand is the back of the hand that, the side that's closest to the sun. Try it again, ready? So in martial arts, we find we have a male side and a female side. Female side is the palm. You use the palm to push down. Back of the hand is the male. You use the male side to strike with. In martial arts, this male side, it's hard enough to go through wood. This female side is hard enough to go through concrete. So that's the way I like to see it, like that. Ready? So I want to go through wood, ready? Oops! Bang, right there, went through it. One hand, other hand is on the hip, saving your energy in your right arm. Try it again. Oops! Oops. Look good with one hand. Ready? Oops. They want to see martial arts, show them one hand. Put one hand on the hip. Work one hand. Show them how good you are with one hand. Ready? Oops. Oops. Good. Now, this time when I do this motion, I'm going to step and slide, and I'm going to strike. Push down, strike, strike. Ready? Work it one hand. I'll give command for each motion. Oops! 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 begin with doing battle with one hand.
Uts! Uts! Uts!
Excellent. Nice. Ready.
Uts! Uts! Uts!
Excellent. Again, the back of the hand can go through wood. Palm heel goes through concrete. So I want him to feel this, but then he felt that. That means I hit a stack of bricks hard, just like that. And hit it again after I hit it one time. Because you can take that power right there. Ready?
Uts! Uts! Uts!
Nice. That's how you're saving your energy. The right hand is resting. Left hand is doing the work. How many of you are left-handed? The ambidextrous, that's where I want to be. I want to be like that. If you're left-handed, you're using your power. If you're right-handed, you're starting to make this arm move better. Give it exercise. Don't have a strong side and a weak side. Give the weak side some exercise too, so we'll go to that left hand. We'll try it again. We'll just give it an exercise. Ready?
Uts! Uts! Uts!
Excellent. Ready?
Uts! 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 Uts!
You guys make it look easy. This time we'll come from here, we'll slide the right foot back to this stance called three. Coming back up. Ready?
Uts. Uts. Uts.
How you get to this perfect stance position, a perfect balance position? All it takes is a second. Try it again. Ready? One. If I counted to my seconds off, it only took 1 second to get to this stance. A millisecond. Now, this time when I move, I'll extend both hands. Right hand is going toward the mirror. It's a strike. Left hand is going toward the corner over there. That's a block. Then I bring my two. I had to hit it 2 times now. Ready?
Uts!
Oh, that's dangerous. Nice. Let's try it again. Ready?
Uts! Uts!
Which hand hit first? Which hand hit last? That means you're switching up what you're doing. If I'm right-handed and I struck hard with the right hand, then the left hand came behind it, that was the harder strike. So I practice on making that hand that's weaker one of the hardest strikes. Let's try it again. Watch how you're working on your left hand. Ready?
Uts!
Oh, that was nice.
Uts! Uts!
It's coming. You want to strike shoulder level. If it's lower than shoulder level, you got weakness there. If it's higher than shoulder level, that's weakness there. Shoulder level is where your power's at. Let's try it again. Ready? And it's your power, no one else's. Your power. Ready?
Uts!
Now, you know that if you can hit this man with your palm heel, if I extend my foot, it's guaranteed to hit the target. The reason why, you measured with your hands. So this time it'll be 1, 2, 3. My kick will go. Ready? Strike, strike, and kick. Make sure you got room. Ready. Or you stagger yourself so you won't be right behind someone. Question.
Are we still doing this or are we just doing this now?
One, two, okay. Three. Good question. Ready.
Butts.
Which foot are we kicking with? All right, the left foot. Ready.
Butts.
Nice, it's coming. Try it again. Your martial arts go to a different level once you start moving hands and feet. You can move hands or you can move feet, but when you move hands and feet, that means it's going to a different level. Ready?
Uts!
Nice. We'll try it again, ready?
Uts!
Excellent. Ready?
Uts!
Excellent. Now, in the art that you study, the way I learned it, the hands will take care of what's at the waist and above. Feet take care of what's at the waist and below. So we'll try it again. Watch how your hands and feet work. Ready?
Butts! Butts!
So if I'm kicking at the waist and below with my foot, where am I kicking to? Groin. Bladder. I put my foot there quick. Ready?
Butts!
Bang! Just like that. Nice. Let's try it again. Ready? Those that are working their breathing, you want to work your breathing when you work your kicks. That means when you lift your knee to kick, I don't want to inhale, because that causes friction right there. A lot of stress in the low abdomen. So when I raise my knee, I'm blowing out. Kicking my foot, I'm blowing out. Make space. Ready?
Butts!
It's coming. You do this technique, blow out. Use this oxygen. Get rid of your carbon dioxide. Ready?
Butts!
I like your technique. Better you work your techniques, the more dangerous you get with your art. Let's try it again, ready? But we say the older you get with your art, the better you get. So you look for age. Ready?
Butts!
That looks good. So I add a motion. Watch my motion. One, two, three, four. Nice. Right hand, left hand, left foot, right elbow. Ready?
Butts!
Excellent. Try it again, ready?
Butts!
Bam! Oh, nice. Coming back, try it again, ready?
Butts!
That looked good right there, nice. Ready?
Butts!
If your foot hits the groin, which way is his head gonna go?
Down.
Down toward you?
Yes.
So that elbow will be right on time. Try it again, ready?
Butts!
It's coming. Good, try it again, ready?
Butts!
This is a powerful group. I like the way that you move. They need to see this across the United States, how you move with focus and control. You're not hurting anyone and no one's hurting you. That's what martial arts was taught to me, focus and control. You don't hurt anyone. You use it to protect yourself. Ready, and this is what we did. We worked technique. Ready,
butts.
How many movements are there?
Four.
How fast can you count to four?
One, two, three, four.
Ready, do that with your movement.
Butts.
One, two, three, four.
Oh, you're finding your speed. That's good for your thoughts. Try it again, Ray. How fast can you count to four?
Butts.
One, two, three, four.
Nice. Ready.
Butts.
One, two, three, four.
Good, it's coming. Ready.
Butts.
One, two, three, four.
Good, it's coming. Ready.
Butts.
One, two, three, four.
Good. Ready.
Butts.
One, two, three, four.
Nice. This time we'll come from here. We'll step to a pedestal. Good, coming back. Ready.
Oops.
First you learn your stances. Perfect. Coming back. That's perfect too, right there. Ready.
Oops.
Picture right there. Let's try it again, ready? I like that. That's age right there. Ready?
Butts.
Nice. What's your stance called?
Cat.
How do you get to the cat stance? Very important. Try it again. Ready?
Butts. Butts.
Demonstrate. When this strike is coming, I don't want to get tense and just stand there like that because I was mad and I knew I was dangerous and mad. That's how you get hurt. This strike is coming, first thing, I go to a cat stance. Left leg is bent, right leg is bent. I just step, get off the straight line. First thing, get away from this danger. That's too much power coming at you. So I take my step. Let's try it again, ready? Watch how you step slide.
Oops.
Step slide, nice. Get to the smallest target possible. Then you come back. You can get to the smallest target possible practicing at home. It's just as simple, just like step slide. Get your body out the way. Protect your body. Ready?
Oops.
First thing, how you got your body out the way?
Oops. Oops.
Everybody I've seen do that with their hands like this, that's because of you. You did that. They saw you do that. And they picked it up like, that's cool. Let's try it again, ready? I like that too. Ready?
Butts.
He tried to strike you, but you moved.
Butts. Butts.
This time we'll come from here and we'll come to this stance, bringing this right hand to this position. Coming back. Ready?
Butts.
Nice. Try again, Ray. Crank.
Butts.
I like that finger right there. That's important. Ready.
Butts. Butts.
Now, this time I'll put the left hand on the back of the right hand. Good. Try it again, Ray.
Butts.
Nice. Ready.
Butts.
Butts.
When this strike is coming, first thing, I started moving to the side, getting out of the way. But then I added one hand. Pull your hand back. Coil like the snake. Then I added two hands. Pull your hand back. Because I'm coiled like the snake. See that finger point? My arm is a roadway to the face. See my strike? One strike. It's a touch. I just needed to touch him. One touch. My left hand pushed my right hand toward the target. My left hand pushes the right hand toward the target. Ready?
Butts. Butts.
That's your strike, snake bite. Ready? All it takes is a touch. When they say martial arts, you gotta be big, sculpted, big muscles. No. Martial artists hit you with like this, like a touch. You're in trouble. This is one of them. If I got to that position and your arm is the roadway to the target, I'm going there. I have to touch it. Ready?
Boots. Boots.
One touch was all it took. Let's try it again. Ready?
Boots.
Nice. Ready.
Butts. Butts.
That's a nice technique. Coming back. Now, this time I come to this position and I'll hit. I'll come to this position and I'll hit. Ready.
Butts. Butts.
Good. Let's try it again. Ready. Question.
I'm guessing that when you do this, you're locking his arm up, right?
Yes.
So when you do this and you push forward on it, you're breaking it because you're...
Oh, that was the second motion. Can I demonstrate the second motion? That was the second motion. When I get to this position, I pick. So it's a break. I can hit the target or I can break from this same position, the same technique. Brilliant. How you get there? One hand is against the wrist. Oh, one part of my arm is against the wrist. Other part of my arm is against the elbow. All I gotta do is pivot. See it?
Good eye, kid.
Ready?
Butts! Butts!
That's a break. Good, coming back. Try it again, ready?
Butts! Butts!
Nice. Try it again. So when you do your hands like this, you know you get different techniques that come from these type of movements. Ready?
Butts. Butts.
Nice. Let's try it again. Ready?
Butts. Butts.
Good. It's got me ready.
Butts. Butts.
Excellent. Ready.
Butts. Butts.
Nice. This time we'll come from here. We'll come to the same stand. Coming back. This time when I move, I'll circle. Like I'm sending my hand toward these windows, going that way. When I do this circle, my other hand will come to this position. Ready.
Butts.
Good, try it again, ready.
Butts.
Excellent. Ready.
Butts.
Nice. Try it again. Ready.
Butts. Butts.
Ready.
Butts.
When they want to know how long you've been doing Tai Chi, tell them ever since you've been doing martial arts. When I'm in this position in Tai Chi, they call that energy ball. I went there. Ready? You went there. How you get to the energy ball? Ready?
Butts!
In Tai Chi, it'll be the energy ball. I got a ball of energy. That's how I get it. Let's try it again, ready? The Tai Chi is also Gung Fu. So they'll take that Tai Chi movement and do something real dangerous with it. Ready?
Butts! 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 Butts!
Now watch my position. This close don't impact. Set it out fast. I brought it back to me. How fast?
Twice as fast.
So it came back to me twice as fast. Ready?
Butts! Butts!
It's coming. Try it again, ready?
Butts! Butts!
Nice! Ready?
Butts! Butts!
Good. My movement. I went to a cat stand to get out of the way. Don't stand right there because that's where he's going to injure you. Learn to protect your body. What's inside of here is worth more than dollars. So you learn to protect it. Next, I made a circle. It was like a circle. I'm sending my hand out toward that window right there. My hand is going that way. My opponent's hand is going that way. But watch the head. See what the head did. When he got caught up in this circle, that took him off balance. You're off balance right there. You know you can make the man go off balance with one finger. So, I took the balance right there. Now, I did an energy ball. Here's my energy ball. Where's my hand at?
Back
of his head. That means I'll hold him there. had a strike. Because that's where he was open. Watch how the strike worked. Energy ball, bam, strike. See it? Ready? He got caught up in your flow. He'll get caught up in the flow in 1 second. Ready?
Butts! Butts!
Now, when I struck with my fist, it was like long arm, dead weight. That's a martial arts system there. Long arms, dead weight, it's called hungar. I want to do a hungar strike. It's like a chain with a spice ball on the end. Ready?
Butts! Butts!
Nice, try it again, ready?
Butts! Butts!
Nice. See, some of the higher ranked students want to add the foot. I can add the foot. So can I demonstrate? When I'm in this position, when I strike the face, I'll strike the leg too. So that will be a break. Ready? So my movements to do this. Ready?
Butts! Butts!
The feet take care of what's at the waist and below. Hands take care of what's at the waist and above. Ready?
Butts! Butts!
I like the motion. Let's try it again. Ready?
Butts!
Nice. Now, this time when I move, I'll ball up. One.
One.
Now, I'll do the same technique. One, two. One, two. Ready? A question.
I didn't ask so many questions, but when you do this, and when you slap it, could you also use the back of your knuckle like this to do more damage?
Yes, you sure can. Watch the motion.
Oh, Dylan, no more questions.
When this hand is down, my knee is up. That's a lot of damage right there. What's in between this hand and that knee, that hit. So I practice that way. It's like, bang. Then I, bow, right there. That's ready?
Butts! Butts!
Nice. Technique after technique after technique. Not just 3 or 4 or 5 techniques, then I've done it all. No. These techniques can take a lifetime, sometimes more than a lifetime. Technique after technique after technique. Ready?
Butts! Butts!
It's coming. Try it again, ready? Look how you ball up, then stretch out. When you ball up, you're dangerous. When you stretch out, you're dangerous. Ready?
Butts! Butts!
That looks good. This time, we'll do the whole technique, one command. When you hear the command, do the whole technique. Ready?
Butts!
Excellent. I heard you blowing out. That's important. Let's try it again. Ready?
Butts!
I like the way that you're blowing out. You're using your breath. Try it again, ready? How you use your breath with your heart. Ready?
Uts!
Excellent. Let's try it again. Ready? Use your breath because the whole body breathes. The body needs this oxygen. It also has a balance. It gets rid of your carbon dioxide. That's good for your internal body. Good for your every cell in the body. Good for the kidneys, good for the heart, good for the lungs. By you standing on one spot, looking in the mirror, and just doing your movements. American physicians will tell you they want to see you move. But they don't come to the martial arts school and see it done the right way. Ready?
Uts!
I saw you ball up, then stretch out. That was a good exercise. Nice. Ready?
Uts!
Another thing I like seeing is the young ones working out with the older ones. That's a beautiful thing. You got to see how beautiful that is. That's nice. And you're showing them the art. An art. We're not looking at the sport. We want to learn the art. That makes you an artiste. You're just working on becoming an artiste through the way that you do movement. We'll try it again. Ready?
Uts!
Nice. We'll come from here. We'll step with the right foot. Coming back. Ready?
Oops.
Front leg is bent. Back leg is straight. This time I want the feet at the 90 degree. Body's at the 45. Front leg is bent. Back leg is straight. Front leg represents female. Back leg represents male. Coming back. Ready?
Uts.
I step to a 45 degree angle. Left shoulder's forward, smallest target possible. It's with the left shoulder forward. Coming back. We'll step with the opposite foot in an angle. Front leg is bent. Back leg is straight. I can point forward and back. Smallest targets from the side. Coming back up. First you learn stances. So if I can't remember what I did today, I'll remember my stances. Ready? We'll step with the right foot. Ready?
Oops. Uts.
There you go. Learn to get your body out of the way.
Uts.
So can I demonstrate? I want to step to my opponent, but I can't step through this brick wall. He's too powerful. Can't afford to walk straight to the target. So I saw him coming, and I made one motion. It was an angle. Smallest targets from the side. Get your body out of the way. First thing, how you practice your angles. Front leg is bent, back leg is straight. I sat down in my movement, lower center of gravity. I came to this side, and I was wondering what the technique would be. So when he strike, I strike. He strikes, I strike. Ready? I'm stepping with the right foot, striking with the left hand. Ready?
Oops.
Nice. Try it again, Randy.
Butts!
There you go. Just like that, huh? Strike right for his head. Try it again, ready.
Butts! Butts! Butts!
He blinked, I'm striking. I see the winds. Then sucked into his stomach, I'm striking. He flinches knee like he's about to move forward, I'm striking. Try it again, ready.
Butts! 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 Butts!
Now, this time I... come to this position. I struck to that position. One, two.
And are you going through him or between him and his arm? I want to go through him.
Very important. We know that. You practice on your own, you're going through him.
That's right.
If no one was there, I'm going through. To protect my opponent, I wouldn't go through. I'll just touch the target. That's where you open. To show him that he can be hit hard, I'll send the strike out to the full extension. So for demonstration, send it to the full extension. If it's a friend, don't hit him like that. If it's combat, go to the full extension. Ready?
Oh, I was gonna say, man,
no knees yet. Which hand are we using?
Left.
That beautiful left hand. Ready?
Butts!
Continue your motion. Nice, try it again, ready? Question?
Doing a half circle, can we do that?
Yes. Okay. You got caught in your flow, and your flow was this circle. When I strike, that was the block. This block can only go so far in the air, then it couldn't go anymore. So immediately it's got to reverse. So I knew that, so I rolled with it. Ready? One command, hold technique.
Butts!
Good, try it again. Let me hear your breathe. Ready?
Butts!
Nice, it's coming. Ready?
Butts! Butts!
Now, watch my position. Something to demonstrate. Watch how the movements work. Still doing the same technique. I went beyond the body so I don't hurt my teammate. Ready? One command, hold technique.
Butts!
It's coming, let's try it again. Where are the strikes going?
Head,
body. Ready?
Butts!
Good. Ready?
Butts!
Nice. again, Randy.
Butts!
Excellent, it's time to be ready.
Butts!
Nice. Ready.
Butts!
Excellent. Move with your iron fist. Ready. Question.
Master Phil, when we do the last punch, boom, boom, should this be blocking high or should it be blocking low?
Okay. I went above, that's there. I would be blocking above. This will protect my face. Good question. Ready? You always protect yourself. If this hand is striking low, the other hand is protecting above. That's good martial arts right there. Always protect yourself. Ready? The protection side of martial arts is just as valuable as the offensive side of martial arts. You're just as deadly if you learn both. A lot of times in our society, we just do offensive. This man is striking and the other man is striking. Nobody blocked. So you learn your blocks. Ready?
Butts!
Good, it's coming. Ready?
Butts!
Good, it's coming, ready.
Butts!
Throw in your strikes, try it again, throw your strikes. The more strikes you start to throw, the more, the stronger your strikes get. So I'm throwing strikes. Ready?
Butts!
Bang. One, two, three. He threw one, I threw three. My three is called a combination. No matter what he did, I'm striking. I don't have to worry about striking and falling down because I caught my balance because I did the correct stance. Ready?
Butts!
How many strikes?
Three.
How fast can you count to three?
One, two, three.
Let me see that with your technique. Ready?
Butts!
One, two, three.
Oh, that was fast. You move, you get it three times, quick. Ready?
Butts!
Bam, bam. It's quick. Ready? You get so good with your art, you can make music with it. It's like I started a beat into my head. Bam, bam. Got it. Ready?
Butts!
Good, it's coming. Struck. I had to hit it. Ready?
Butts!
One, two, three.
Nice. Throw in your iron fist. I like that. Ready?
Butts!
One, two, three.
Coming back. This time, we'll come from here, we'll come to this position. It's like strike. Good, try it again, ready? It's like this strike went above, but then it went below. Nice, coming back. I like that stance right there. That's a dangerous martial arts stance. Ready?
Butts!
Those that have been with me for a while, what's my stance?
Female.
Female. I've been to the female stance. I'm a dangerous martial artist. Female stance. That's a dangerous stance. Ready?
Butts!
It's coming, try it again, ready.
Butts! Butts!
I taught many students, a I've taught students that went and took Chinese writing as a course. And they told me that by looking at my class, they realized that the Chinese writing, the writing letters, is like your martial arts. The letters themselves, they'll find martial arts in that. One of them was this motion right here. They said, Master Selmon, when you hit that motion right there, that's the letter in Chinese writing that represents female. That's it right there. You're not only doing the art, you're doing the writing through the movements that you're doing. It's extremely important in certain cultures. It could be that important with you guys out here too. You went to a female stance, that's like Chinese writing. That's old and ancient. They'll look at that, you do that motion and able to pick a letter out of their dictionary and say, that's what you're doing. Just by you studying the art. Again, when I take my step, I'm going to make a fist and go to that position. Coming back. Ready?
Oots!
Nice. Coming back, ready.
Uts. 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 Uts.
Now watch my position. Hand went down, but then I brought it up. My left hand went to my chest like. Before my hand went to my chest, I lift my knee. Now I bring the foot down and I extend my hand as long, far as I can go. We'll try it slow. Stride. Step in. Right hand came up, right knee came up. Hand touched the chest. Bringing the foot down and extend my hand. Try it again. We'll do it slow like Tai Chi. Ready?
Oots!
Good. Right hand comes up and I lift the right knee. Bring your hands to your chest. Extend your foot that was up and extend your hand down. Good. Try it again. The more moves you do, the more advanced they get. I was struck at. Couldn't afford to stay right here. What was my stance?
Female.
First thing. How I got to the stance and got out of the way. My stance got me out of the way. If he was throwing kicks, I'm protected. And the female stance. The opposite of the female stance is the male horse stance. When he struck at me, bam, I'm striking. At the same time, I brought my hand to the pelvis. I brought my hand up and I'll use my knee. Same time you see his eyes, you get your eyes taken out. When I stretch, when the dragon stretch, something gets broke. You see the position. So watch how it flows. He's like, God is my flow. In that position. Tell him where you feel your tightness at.
Shoulder, yep, my knee.
Now, my combat. I'm going to bring his hand to my knee. This is where I want to bring his head over to that knee right there. Be like, bam, then bam, he catch both knees.
Is that a Pukulon add-on?
Well, I just call it Gung Fu. It's Gung Fu. It's one of those systems.
Yeah, so.
Take your time through that move. It's more advanced. The elders might have it easier. The young ones might struggle. But then you're able to reach back and help those that are struggling. Let's try it again, ready? You got a technique. You're gonna do it slow.
Butts.
What's the stance?
Female. Yeah.
Knee comes up. Hit the eye. Stretch it. When the dragon stretch, something gets broke. Dragon. When I'm stretching and dragging, try it again, ready?
Butts.
Ball up. Stretch out. Nice. All you're doing is balling up, then stretching back out. Ready?
Butts.
Nice. Coming back. Ready?
Butts.
Good, coming back. So I see on the shirts, they say if you can't do it slow, you can't do it fast. That means you got to slow down your thoughts. Even the slow way is exercise. That slow way is good for your body. So you take it slow and gentle. Don't hurt yourself. But that's extremely important to be able to do that. This time we'll come from here, we'll come to this position. The same position you did at first. This time I'm bringing my fist to this position. Ready?
Butts.
Bringing my elbow toward my navel. Fist is pointing toward the mirror. Ready? So I'm ready.
Butts.
Butts. Coming back, ready?
Butts.
That looked good, good. Let's try it again, ready?
Butts.
It's coming, ready?
Butts.
And Mr. Forte, could I demonstrate with you? I chose Mr. Forte. He's one of my students from way back when. He also taught on the colleges. He became a college professor. He's still with the colleges, and he gets a lot of respect for the art that he does. He's throwing a strike. I don't want to get caught right there. That man is too powerful for me to take a strike like that. So I saw it coming. I came to this position. This is the female system. I learned to go with it, not against it. His power is going toward the back wall. I just went with his power. His power is going that way. I didn't try to muscle up and go against the man like, huh, my big strong muscles will take over this big man. It won't happen. But I can't go with this power. I came for this position. Smallest target possible was from the side. Now, when I'm going with it, I'm striking. Can you see the position? I went with his power, and I sent mine at the same time. Now, my object is to get between his hands. Right now, I'm on the outside. But then I bring this one down and I strike. Both of his hands are down. Mine is on top. Whose hand will make it to his face first? His or mine?
Yours.
Bam! Because he was open. So here's my motion. One, two, three. Thank you, sir. One, two, three. Ready?
Butts!
It's coming. Try it again. Ready?
Butts!
There you go. You got long arms. Here's the third one. That's the fourth one. Nice. Try it again. Ready?
Butts!
Bless you, baby. Long arms with dead weight. That's a system. They call it hung up. So my movements went bang, bang, bang. This was my power this way now. Change the strike. This way, this way, this way, that way. Long arms, dead weight is hung up. It's like you're lifting 2x4s. You're striking the man with 2x4s. Ready?
Butts!
Nice, that looked good right there. Ready?
Butts!
Nice, try it again, ready? Like your hung up. Ready? Long arms, dead weight.
Butts!
Nice, it's coming, ready.
Butts!
Good, coming back. Sir, can I demonstrate? When this strike is coming, I'm coming to this position, and I strike. Now, watch when I bring this hand down. Is he open?
Yep. You okay?
Bam! Ready?
Butts!
One. Two. Three. Four. Ready? Butts block. Strike hung up. Over the hurdle. Stroke. Nice. Let's try it again, ready? You're doing a hung guard technique. Some of you will gravitate toward that type of system and want every hung guard technique you can find. Some of you did tiger strikes or working your tiger movements. Some of you learn those tiger movements and that's all you want to get is what everything you can get tight. Some of you stretch with the dragon motion. You'll be looking for that invisible system called the dragon. Me myself, I've been looking, I haven't found it yet, but I guess I still hold those techniques. So you play with the different systems as you go through your martial arts as you age. Age like fine wine, the diamond in the rough. The more you polish that diamond, the more it will shine. Ready? We're gonna work this movement. I forgot the movements. You gotta show me now. Ready?
Hooks!
Something. That was nice. Let's try it again, ready? Your hand and foot combinations. Make sure martial arts go to a higher level. Ready?
Butts!
That's it right there. And you were done. You did your exercise and it was done. Yep, it goes with that flow. Ready?
Butts!
Good, it's coming. This time we'll come from here, Will. Good, try to get ready.
Uts.
Nice, try to get ready.
Uts.
Bam, right there, you attack. Try to get ready. It's like you were in a dangerous situation. You could run, but they'll come after you. So you decided to strike. I'm in a dangerous situation, I'm striking. So to be in that situation, to do it with no practice, that'll make you weak. It's better to practice that way. So I want to strike it. He flinched, I'm hitting him. Ready?
Uts!
Bam, right there, I tried to hit him. Try it again. You see how you're standing on this line? When I stake my step, I want to be on the next line. That means my weight is behind my strike. Ready?
Uts!
That was the weight behind the strike, I could tell. Try it again, ready?
Uts! 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 Uts!
Now, this time I move my left foot with the right hand. Nice, coming back. Now I'll to that position. Ready?
Uts!
There you go. Block. Protect yourself. Ready?
Uts!
Now, I don't want it to be in front of my face. I want it to be higher than my head because they'll strike you in your head. Let's try it again. Ready?
Uts!
Excellent. Let's try it again, Brady.
Uts!
Nice, it's coming, Brady.
Uts!
Good, coming back. The game for a fan demonstration. You're in a fighting stance. I'm coming from this position. I attack. I'm attacking. In martial arts, you got offense and defense. In offense, you attack. So I get to this position. You're in a fighting stance. I attack. This man has to counter. It's self-defense. Defense, he blocks. I'm in this position. Then I came to this position. Where did I put his hands?
Above.
Look at his face. Because the elbows is there. So I'm coming. One, two, three. He's a good martial artist because he blocked his face. You don't let anything hit you. You block everything that comes to your body. Thank you, sir. So now it's like one, two, three. We'll come to the horse stand. Ready?
Butts!
Try to get ready.
Uts!
Good demonstration. Fight stance. I'm coming to this position. I struck. My next strike, straight to the target. Good martial artist will block whatever comes to him. So them hands got to be there to protect themselves. Nice. Ready.
Butts.
Just turn your body this way, your opponent, that. Turn your side to your opponent. So you turn all the way to the side. That's what you're going to do. Ready.
Butts.
Four steps.
Daniel's right there. He can hit the bag. Good. Try it again. Ready. Question.
After we do the strike, are we still? Should we still hold on to the hand, or do we bring it back here? See everybody doing this. Can I keep the hand?
You throw in your punch. I went to this position. Here's my block. So I didn't grab. This is where you open. Okay. So I didn't have to grab. You're in a fighting stance. I went to this position, and I'm striking. Bam, that's where he's going. Ready, didn't grab. To grab, it takes too long. Too much extra thought. It's like, bam, bam, bam. It's fluid. Ready with snap. Ready.
Uts.
You finally try it again, ready. Good, coming back. This time we'll come from here. We'll Look at your wrist. Good. Now, this time when I step, I'm going to be sliding back. When I slide back, I'll... Ready.
Oops.
Nice. Now, when I'm sliding back, if my body's on this line right here, watch the body. Is the body still on that line?
Yes, sir.
That means I slid back, but my body didn't move. I'm still on this line. Ready. A flick of your wrist. Ready.
Oops.
There you go. A flick of your wrist. That means you'll put that man's eye out. I'll come from above and flick right down on his eye. Ready? Or I'll come from underneath and I'll flick his eye that way. Or I'll come from this side and flick his eye that way. Or I'll go to the other side and I'll flick his eye the other way. Any way I move, I'll hit him in the eye. Don't give him a chance. This time you're stepping back and you're flicking him into the eye, just like flicking your wrist. Ready? That's all the power you need. Ready?
Butts!
Good. Try it again. Ready? The left hand is blocked as I stroke. Left hand full extension. I block. Ready?
Butts!
Good. Try it again. Ready?
Butts.
Watch how you step back, but your body didn't go back. That's important. Ready?
Butts. Butts.
Looking good right there. Ready?
Butts. Butts.
Now, this time when I move, I'll strike. Then I bring my hands and foot up. Then I reach down low. We'll do it slow. Ready?
Oops.
Continue your motion. Try it again, Randy. And you tell him it's on your shirt. You can't do it fast. You can't do it slow. You can't do it fast. So we slow it down, Randy. Let me see your flow. Oops. Let's try it again, Randy. Nice, it's coming, ready. Uts. Nice, ready. Uts. Excellent. Ready. Uts. It's coming. Ready. Uts. Nice. Ready. Nice. Now, the movements you're doing now is soft. So I don't want to move hard. I want to move more fluid, like. Ready. Look how you move soft and fluid and still be dangerous. Ready? Oots! It's gonna be ready. Oots! Excellent. Try it again, Randy. Uts. Excellent. You can move soft or you can move hard. This time we'll move hard. Watch my position. Soft and it did like this. But then I did it hard and it did like this. This time we're going to the hard move. Ready. The softer movement, I took a step back. But my body didn't go back. I stayed there. And the forward move, the harder movement, I move forward. Bang, bang, bang. Chomp. So you got both. I can move soft and gentle, or I can move hard and fast. Ready? Now we're moving hard and fast.
Hold it back.
Now I'm stepping forward. It's like one, two, three, four. Oh. My last strike, where's my strike going?
Groin.
That means what I grab, I'll squeeze. Once I squeeze, I chop it out of my hand. I just want to squeeze, chop it out of my hand. Ready? Uts! There you go. You learn to chop it out of your hand, you got to practice it. Over and over again. Ready? Uts! Oh, that's what it should be. That's a combination. Ready? Uts! Nice. Try it again. Ready? Uts! And when I do that movement, the foot should be in there too. I can bring my feet into that motion. That's the way it's done. It's like going over the hurdles. The same way you did it the first time with the soft movement. So now it's like, bang, 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 bang. So not only do I grab the groin, I kick the groin. Kick the grab, chop it. That's the technique. Ready? Your hand and foot combination. He threw one strike, he did this. It was on the man his own. Ready? Uts! You move. Never satisfied with your speed and your thought. Your brain can work even on a higher level than that. And it takes practice to find those higher levels. How you change your body, not only externally, but internally. How you change your mind with the speed of your thought. It's a whole different way of studying. And it's very old and very ancient. Ready? Did you hear the sound you move? Move! That's good focus and control. Uts! Good, try it again, ready? Uts! Okay, it's coming. Still use your breath. Good, using this diaphragmatic muscle. That's the diaphragmatic muscle. In the Orient, they call that the second heart. I learned to use the second heart with my technique. All you have to do is blow it. Ready? Working your speed. Uts! Nice. I'm trying to try it again. Never satisfied with the speed that you have. You can always move faster. You can move faster. How it works is the speed of your thought. A person that's got good speed of thought, that's a dangerous individual. This is how you practice your speed of thought. You got a technique. It's in your mind. You ready to move on. No one was there, just you by yourself. That means you can move as fast as you can. Ready? Uts! Oh, it's coming. Back, 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 back. Nice. Try it again. Ready? Uts! Excellent. Let's try it again, Ray. Uts! Now, don't forget your body motion. I'm here. Then I went left shoulder. Then I went right shoulder. Then I chopped. Ready? Don't forget your body motion. Ready?
Butts!
All those movements are working. Try it again, ready? Moving at the speed of your thought. How fast is your thought? The teachers I study from say, to understand the speed of your thought, you guys, you can understand the speed of light. You're working on that. How do you get to the speed of light thinking? In your Gung Fu. You got a technique. You're gonna play with it. Ready? You work trying to find the speed of your thought. Ready?
Butts!
The mind was working.
Butts!
Coming back. Now you gotta think, how many neurons did it take for you to do that technique?
2.5
Skeet! Skeet!
Skeet!
He would go forever, so I had to cut it out.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, sir. Thank you guys for inviting me out. I came on out and I tried to do my thing the best of my ability.
Formation?
Right.
Thank you, big bro.
Thanks, teacher. Peace, sir. Thank you, sir.
Before everyone heads out, can we get one big picture with everyone? Because I don't know the last time I've seen both of you guys in the same spot.
Yeah, seriously.
So we got to do the head.
So let's go ahead. Let's have everyone face this way.